Well, happy Valentine's Day, everybody. It is February 14th, Monday. I'm getting ready to head out and celebrate Valentine's Day by going to a dental appointment. Let's get that out of the way this morning. Just a teeth cleaning in general. I'm going to get my oil changed and tires rotated, I think. For all the people that really were excited about it, you know, congratulations to the LA Rams for winning the Super Bowl. I was working on a project called Scary Pockets yesterday, and we were in from, God, I don't know, 10 in the morning till about 7:30 last night. So needless to say, did not see or experience any of the game, but always grateful to be working. And that takes precedence over a lot of things. And we had a great time, really a fun day. What a fun cast of characters in the studio. It was nice to be over at East West. I always like working at that studio. I have some of my longest history with that studio going back to when it was originally Western of the United Western Complex. But being Valentine's Day, somebody reminded me of this yesterday, and I was completely forgot about it. And I'm going to go ahead and play a song now. Now, I've talked about this album in the past, but not this song. And that's with the group America. And on their album Alibi from 1980, there's a song called Valentine on it. Now, the band on this is myself, Mike Baird, Jerry Buckley and Dewey Bunnell, who are America, and then the guitar sections. Not too bad, not a shoddy guitar section. Dean Parks, Waddy Wachtel, Fred Mullen, and Steve Lukather in here with James Newton Howard and Jay Winding and Jerry Buckley on keyboards and Norton Buffalo on harmonica. Let's see what we got here. Willie Leacox on percussion, and it was produced by Fred Mullen and Matthew McCauley, who I did a number of albums with over the years, engineered by Eric Prestige, and mixed by Bill Schnee and mastered by Mike Reese over at Mastering Labs. So I'm going to go ahead and play this in honor of Valentine's Day for everybody out there, and I hope everybody has just a wonderful day, and think about, you know, your Valentines in your life, and also just think about people as a daily Valentine of just thoughtfulness and caring about each other would be a really nice thing to do. So here we go. This is Valentine by America. Nice way to start the week, too.
Well, I said all along, I'm the one with thin nail polish, chewing gum around the world, hard nail, fighting numb, that's right. She looks like a China doll, baby, especially in white, a tropical flower in the candlelight. Sweet kiss.
usually hear Valentine's songs as these real tender little love ballads. That's pretty great that they approached Valentine as a just a nice big shuffle, kick-ass shuffle. So happy Valentine's Day, everybody out there. It's have just a lovely day. A reminder, this coming Wednesday is our live stream clubhouse. So for all of you that are in the clubhouse, I look forward to seeing you on Wednesday. I just got to get my shit together here and get ready to drive out to the dentist. It's a rush hour all the way across, a long drive at rush hour. So I'm going to leave a little bit early and get over there in glorious anticipation of sitting in the chair and getting work done. Let's see, what else? Anything else? I'm trying to think. Had a lovely talk with Tim Pierce yesterday. We were going to get together, maybe do a little video together for both of our sites. It'd be really fun. I love Tim. He's really such a good cat. There's been a few passings, which is really sad. I saw yesterday on the news that Ivan Reitman had passed away, the producer-director. And I did a whole bunch of movies, worked on music for a bunch of his stuff, from Kindergarten Cop and Twins, Dave. They were showing a whole list of his movies, and I went, oh, God, I worked on that. Oh, I worked on that one, too. So it was pretty sad to see he had passed. He had a really fun legacy, a lot of great films. And Dave is still one of my all-time favorites. Every time I watch Dave, I go, why the hell can't this job be this easy and make this much sense? Because they took the presidency and just turned it into something really right by having a guy in there who just did the job. You know, it's just really, I love that movie. And Kevin is just an amazing actor. So I'm going to get running here. I'm going to send especially greetings out to everybody working in the hospitals. We were talking about this yesterday on the session, and how many musicians we know in town that are, they're losing their gigs that they've had for years because they refuse to follow protocols and get vaccinated, or they don't want to wear a mask and all this. It's unbelievable. Guys willing to give up their careers over this. It's unbelievable. And we all just sit there and go, okay, whatever, it's your call. But man, all those folks that are just, you know, celebrating Valentine's Day, working in the hospitals and stuff. It's amazing. Just tragic for them. I'm so sorry that things are getting better, but it's come to this. I'm very hopeful that we don't see a huge spike after yesterday's game, looking at that stadium, and at least when the cameras are panning the crowd out there, hardly a mask to be seen. So we'll see. But for the moment right now, I'm just going to say happy Valentine's Day to everybody out there. And I will see you tomorrow. I'm going to get going now. But thank you, America, for doing Valentine. It's a pretty cool version there. So okie dokie, I will see you all tomorrow. Bye-bye.